In this video, I want to demonstrate how to make this part of the movable jaw, but I also want to point out the arrow over here at the end of each feature. That tells us it was made in the context of the assembly, and that it has references to other parts in the assembly. Those references can become a problem later, but a little later we'll look at how to deal with them and whether or not we want to keep the external references or not. When we're creating the part, we typically want them. It makes it easier to fully define, but sometimes we need to remove them later. The other thing I want to do before I forget is right-click on this sliding jaw, and again, save it externally. So I'm going to just click Save Part in External File, accept the default folder, and say OK. So now I'm going to Control Tab back to my other part, and I'm going to rotate around, and I want to make sure I'm editing this jaw before I do anything else. So I'm going to select it, and I'm going to tell it to edit the part, and again, I know I'm editing it because everything else goes see-through. So I'm going to look normal to this face, and I'm going to tell SOLIDWORKS that I want to make an extrusion. I'm going to use the two-point rectangle, and I'm going to start from this corner and just come down here and get the coincident to that edge that's orange, and I'll activate Smart Dimension using mouse gestures. From this edge to here, it's 0.225. That's now fully defined. I'm going to use mouse gestures again to activate Circle, and I'll wake up this hole in the other part, and I'll lock this circle center to the other circle center. So I'll move out and click and create it. Use mouse gestures to activate Smart Dimension. And I'm going to add the dimension size of 0.21. My sketch is fully defined. I'm just going to rotate a little bit. And I'll right click and exit the sketch. And this extrusion, we're going to make 3/8 going in the other direction. And I'll say OK. And once again, I've now created that. I'm still working in the part, in the context of the assembly, and I know this because this is blue and everything else see-through. So I'm going to stop editing that part, and again,